Hello everyone, I am Vinita Taylor from LP Savani School. Today we learn about operating system. Today's topic is operating system, need of an operating system, function of an operating system, features of an operating system, example of an operating system. Operating system. Let's see, the first topic is operating system. Operating system is a system software that manages computer hardware and software. It usually stored on the hard disk of a computer. It master control for program of a computer. Operating system is the master control program of a computer. It acts as a middleman between the hardware and software. Without an operating system, a computer hardware and software would be useless to a common user. Operating systems are found on many devices that contain a computer, from cellular phone and video game console to web servers and supercomputers. Let's see operating system. Operating system handle the hardware and applications also. Here in image, hardware is monitor, printer, mouse, keyboard, hard drive. And applications, different types of applications like LP Savani School imprint applications, Microsoft Word, and all other applications are handled by operating system. Operating system is a middleman between the user and hardware. This show in second image. Need of an operating system. First of all, why we need of an operating system? Because operating system is the middleman between the hardware and the software. So there are four types of need an operating system. First of all, operating system control the hardware and software resources. Second, operating system makes the computer screen and device look and behave same on any computer. Portability. An operating system ensured that an application developed by a programmer on one computer functions on another computer of the same type, even if the two computers have different storage space or memory. Fourth one is upward compatibility. Various applications continue to function normally on a computer even if its hardware is upgraded in future. This all task is done by an operating system. So for controlling hardware and software resources, we need an operating system. Functions of an operating system. Many functions are performed by an operating system, but the main goal of an operating system is to provide the interface between the user and hardware. It acts as an intermediary that allows the user to communicate with the computer. The various functions performed by an operating system are explained below. First is process management, memory management, device management, file management, interface management. First is process management. CPU is the main component that execute the instruction given to the computer. CPU can perform one task at one time. If there are many tasks, operating system decide which tasks the CPU should get first. Second is memory management. The memory cannot be managed without an operating system. The memory management takes care of allocation and reallocation of memory space to the various program. You know that various type of applications are run on the computer. So these all applications require space. So this all space is managed by memory management. If there is no operating system, the program may mix with each other. The system will not work properly. Third is file management. Computer data are stored on secondary storage device. File management involves a keeping track of all different files where the data is stored, maintaining the integrity of data stored in the file and directory. Computer uses a lot of data and programs, so file management is necessary. And this is handled by an operating system. The file management system allows the user to perform such tasks as creating the files and directories, renaming the files, copying and moving the files, and deleting files. Third is device management. A computer equipped equipped with several different types of devices. An operating system also controls all devices attached to the computer. Devices like printer, monitor, keyboard, mouse, etc. are attached with the computer. These all devices checked by device management and controls by device management. Fifth one is interface management. An operating system controls the interaction of the computer with users and other applications. So operating system is a middleman. So computer system, its work as an interface between the user and applications. So it is all task is developed by interface management. Let's see, next topic is features of an operating system. An operating system is a program that act as an interface between the software and the computer hardware. It is integrated set of specialized program used to manage overall resources and operations of the computer. It is specialized software that controls and monitors the execution of all other programs resided in a computer, including application programs and other operating system. Example of an operating system. So there are various types of operating system available in market. First is Windows, Windows 8, Linux, Fedora, Mac OS, Ubuntu, Android. Another is FreeBSD, Solaris and MS-DOS. These all are operating system. Now we learn types of operating system, user interface as it and its types, Windows GUI, advantages of GUI. Types of an operating system. There are various type of operating system: single user and multi user, real time, distributed, interactive and batch operating system. Now we start single user and multi user operating system. A single user operating system works on more than one task and process them concurrently at a time. On the other hand, multi-user operating system enable multiple users to use the resources of computer system simultaneously and at a different types. Example of single user system is DOS. It means disk operating system, and multi-user system is Unix, and Linux is multi-user operating system. Now real-time operating system, it is used for managing the control machinery, scientific instruments and industrial system. It manages the computer resources and handles the operation in a precise way by providing the equal amount of time. In a real-time operating system, processing time requirements are calculated in tens of seconds increments of time. It is a time-bound system that can be defined as fixed time constraint. You see that real-time operating system is calculated in tens of seconds increment of time. In this type of operating system, processing must be done inside the specified constraint, otherwise the system will fail. So this is a real-time operating system. Now distributed operating system. The computers works in cooperation with each other. This operating system manages group of independent computers. What operating distributed operating system doing? This distributed operating system manages group of independent computers and makes them appear to be a single computer. It is known as distributed operating system. Example of distributed operating system is Linux and Windows 2007. Now interactive and batch operating system. An interactive operating system allows the user or other programs to perform input output at any time during processing. So in interactive operating system, we perform program of input and output at any time during our processing. But in batch operating system does not allow intermediate input and output. Windows is an interactive OS, while IBM's and MVS is a batch processing OS. In figure, we do that batch operating system input data and output data there is no intermediate input output in between. In online and interactive operating system, you do interactive with input and output also. Several different types of user interfaces have been designed for different purposes. The common two types of user interface are CUI and GUI. CUI it means character user interface, and GUI it means graphical user interface. CUI user interface. CUI means you have to take help of the keyboard to type the commands. These are no images and graphics on the screen, and it is a primitive type of interface. While now GUI it means graphical user interface. GUI makes use of graphics, images and other visual clues such as icons. This interface made it possible for a mouse to be used with a computer, and interaction really become very easy to use. User could interact with just a click of the mouse rather than having to type a commands to the computer. Now, advantages of GUI. GUI is a user friendly and easier to use than CUI. We can work on more than one software in GUI, which is generally not possible in CUI. It means command line user interface. This interface uses graphics and images. Everyone know that GUI uses images and graphics for interface. This interface uses graphics and images with multimedia support. User can interact with the computer with clicks of the mouse, and there is no need to type the commands as an CUI. So GUI is better than a CUI. Now the key points to remember is: an operating system is required for controlling the hardware and software resources of the computer. Without an operating system, a computer hardware and software would be useless. Now then, after we use the types of operating system, a single user operating system works on more than one task and processes them concurrently at a time, while multi-user operating system enables multiple users to use the resources of a computer system simultaneously and at different times. In CUI user interface, commands are typed with the help of the keyboard, and in GUI user interface uses images and graphics for interaction. GUI is user friendly and easier to use than CUI. So this all about the operating system. I hope you understand this all topics very well. Thank you.